Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're headed to Outer Heaven. I know I was supposed to put this mask on, but I want to see what happens if we don't just yet. And away we go. I forget exactly why we're supposed to go here, but I know it's a lead of what's going on with the Snatchers, or what was going on with our friend who died. the Junker that we're now taking over for, or what's going on. I know we're looking for a doctor who bought... We're going to end up looking for a doctor who bought a whole case load of sunscreen, which the Snatchers use to stop the sun from giving their fake skin cancer. Anyway, we've arrived at Outer Heaven. Oh boy. Well, this is a mask. This is Outer Heaven. Otherwise, I'd be very alarmed right now.
Welcome to Outer Heaven! Table for one?
We don't have our mask on, though. Parker? He's wearing a Wolfman mask. Looks like a movie set or something. His face is covered, but he appears to be rather short. This is kind of interesting. With the masks on, you can't even tell if somebody you know is here. Isabella Velvet Dance Show. Look, it's that famous actress. It's Isabella Velvet. Yes, from the poster, yes, I would gather that is the case. Otherwise known as the Marilyn Monroe of the 21st century, she's here? Wow. Can't believe we can meet her. She's almost never seen in public. Metal Gear seems a little starstruck here. The sign says, Masquerade Hour now in progress. The sign for Masquerade Hour is displayed. This is the most lively nightlife district in Neo Kobe. It's a very lively nightlife district. The doormen are all working hard to get customers into their clubs. It's a 200-degree holographic poster of Isabella Velvet. I would really like to have one. Metal Gear saying that. Oh my, if you look down from above the poster, you can see everything. Jesus, whose personality is in this guy? Well, I'll be. You could see him. Look at the size of those peaks.
Oh jeez. Excuse me.
You're excused. It says, during Masquerade Hour, our patrons are requested to conceal themselves with masks or makeup. Your cooperation is appreciated. Please consult our staff for any questions you may have. It's a special notice about the rules during Masquerade Hour. Just pulling the string until there's nothing, no text left. There are numerous shops selling adult merchandise on both sides of the street. You don't want to bother with those other places. They're sheer boredom compared to Outer Heaven, the doorman says. After all, we can author things that those other places can't. You mean illegal activities? Well, some people may use that terminology, but... We were up to this. So many places are so tightly packed in, it's almost difficult to tell the different ones apart. There are numerous shops selling adult merchandise on both sides of the street. Okay, let's investigate this guy. Hey! What do you think you're doing? Metal Gear says it's an extensive makeup job. This doesn't come off easily. Not in the same league as my mask, huh? This is a professional job. Hey, stop that. Gibson. What are you talking about? I don't work out here every day, you know. The staff in the club may know something. Oh, jeez. Are you allergic to robots or something? You can ask me as many times as you want, but the answer won't change. Let's get something about Outer Heaven. You found the place! Welcome to Outer Heaven! That's right. As you can see, our specialty is our masquerade hour. Buffalo cuisine restaurant? I have to be careful when I say this, but our buffalo is the best in the world. Oh, okay, so it's another lead. It's a genuine wild thing. No genetic manipulation. Okay. So, we found that Jean, which was the friend's name that we're taking over, being a junker for, the name I couldn't remember, his name is Jean Gibson, he had buffalo meat in his stomach, so he was apparently dining here just 3 hours before he was killed. Why don't you try some before you go? We got a special arrangement with Plato's Cavern. If you don't buy one of their masks, I'm afraid you can't get in. I'm afraid we don't let those types in. We have to maintain a certain degree of class, you know. We've been seeing a lot of imitations lately. It's a big problem for us, you know. Okay. It's called the black market, but the distribution system is first rate. Well, having you buy a mask is a form of membership system. We used to sell the masks right here until recently. Now you can only get them at Plato's Cavern. It's close by. Just want to see what he says. Come on, you must have seen the commercials for Plato's Cavern. I'm quite sure that the phone number for the place is public information. I've been there before, Gillian says. Well, then that makes everything easy. Bless you. Is he allergic to his own mask? Why don't you just call them and ask? Alright, let's ask about Isabella. That's the real Isabella. You don't get very many chances to see such a famous actress in person, you know. Puts on a dance show every hour. No tricks, just one hot program. Alright, let's show him some of this stuff. Can I use the mask? Yeah. Show him the mask. Put that on before you go in. Gibson photo. Didn't say anything. Is there something wrong with this man? Why'd you ask him if there's something wrong? Don't know him. Come on, let me jog your memory a little bit more. I don't know. Oh, what's with that? I meant to hit key. Just curious of what he will say for the key and the other stuff.
I don't know. It's
You're excused. What's with that? He doesn't have anything to say about any of this stuff. What's that? See if I can go inside without a mask, what happens? Wait a minute, please. We're in the middle of a masquerade hour. You'll need some kind of mask or costume if you want to go in. Excuse me, sir. I'm afraid you'll need to wear a mask in order to go in. That's what you just said. Sorry for the trouble, but you'll have to wear your mask to get in. Alright, we're gonna have to. Alright. Just wanted to see what would happen if we insisted. Alright, let's try on the mummy mask. Oh, that looks great on you. Alright, let's go in. Table for one, please. It's dark. Hey, now there's a show. We're inside outer heaven. We're outside inner heaven. Okay. The other customers are all dressed up in various costumes. It appears to be showtime now. Who's the guy over behind the counter? He appears to be the manager of the place. There don't seem to be any tables off open. The place appears to be quite popular. Everyone is dressed up as a character from a classic late 20th century video game. Oh, so I haven't really looked at them. Okay. I think I see Duke Nukem. Is that Snake? To the left of Duke Nukem and... I don't know who that anthropomorphic character is. We have Dracula and Simon? Castlevania, maybe? Not sure who else. The people who run this place must be really into old-time nostalgia. Here I am, playing a retro game. I was right, Castlevania pair. Oh, Contra. The two guys from Contra, not Duke Nukem. And I don't know these. Sparkster? Hey, isn't that the guy who fought against the evil pigs from the Devotindos Empire? Oh yeah, the rocket guy. What's his name? Spinster? Spunster? Parkster? That customer's dressed as the hero Sparkster, the Rocket Knight. Yeah, I'm not familiar with that one. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. Gemin? Goman? Goman the Mystical Ninja. You're right. Boy, that was really a great game. Those designers were really brilliant. The Goman haircut became a real cultural icon. Japanese motorcycle gangs started to all wear their hair like that. He is just as the video game hero Goman or Gemin the Mystical Ninja. Mr. Ueda? That fellow is dressed as a character from the controversial video game Lethal Enforcers. It caused quite a stir in the 1990s when two senators from the United States started a two-man crusade against video game violence. Those same two senators were later voted out of office in a humiliating landslide when their constituents decided that they wanted representatives who would do something about real violence on the streets. Oh yeah, I believe that game also spawned a whole generation of imitations, didn't it? Lethal Enforcer. It sounds vaguely familiar. Yep, that's true. A lot of companies produced inferior copies, but none matched the success of the original. I mean, they would definitely have some commentary going on here. As a matter of fact, that game was used in the Academy for training purposes. It's amazing how people can use a simple video game as an excuse for all of society's problems. It's always easier to point the figure at the other guy than it is to point it at yourself. Human nature hasn't changed at all since then, huh? Okay, this is the most text for any description in the game so far. The Chinese boss from Lethal Enforcer is right. Now this I know, Contra. The customer is dressed as the Contra character. I'm starting to sense a theme here. How about you, Gillian? Yeah, me too. I guess you and I are pretty out of place among all these Konami characters on Metal Gear. I wouldn't say that. As a matter of fact, I suspect that we fit in much better than you realize. Haha. What the heck are you talking about, Metal? These are all fictional video game characters. We're the only real ones in here. Sure about that, Gillian? That's the Contra guy. We shouldn't mess with him too much. I was curious if they say anything else about the Contra guy. Okay. Castlevania pair. Those two are pretty suspicious looking. They appear to be dressed as characters from the famous Castlevania series of video games from the late 20th century. Yeah. Wow, that really takes me back. I remember spending hours playing it. I didn't even take time off to sleep. Wait a minute. What am I talking about? I wasn't even born then. I must be thinking about something else. But I'm pretty sure I remember playing it. I remember I was so pissed because I couldn't jump off the stairs. Yeah, really. Is he talking about the first game? Everyone felt that way, Gillian. It was very frustrating. According to statistical records, this teenage society rate, the teenage suicide rate increased dramatically in that year. Oh, come on. I don't think that's true, and if it was, it's not because of Castlevania. That is Simon Belmont and the Master of Evil, Dracula. At least I was right about those two. Save of the moment, Gillian. Her dancing is really something special. I see. You weren't kidding, were you? Gillian, what are you staring at? What do you think? Wow, she really knows how to move her body. During masquerade hour, everybody has a mask or makeup on. It's impossible to tell who is who. Investigate Sparkster. Hey, what are you doing? Oh, he turned around. The customer wasn't carrying anything suspicious. Get that out. What do you think you're doing? Gemin or Gemin? Okay, note of that one too. I'm just gonna investigate each one once. Ueda? Watch it! What's your problem? Looks like he's a DJ. Contra. Unfortunately, we couldn't learn anything. Push my luck with Contra. Okay. Alright. Order? Oh, we can order food. We can call, order. We can exit. Not sure if this is a good idea. Show my junker ID.
What the? Hey, this guy's a junker! Hey! He sells a junker over here!
Oh, you gotta be kidding!
You're in the wrong joint, buddy! Forget about the check! Just get out of my place now!
I had a feeling. It appears that we have been thrown out. Doorman says, sorry, but we have to maintain an atmosphere in which our customers can relax, you know. I'm sorry, I was a bit rash. Will you let me in now, please? Sorry, it's not a good time right now. The same customers are still in there, you know. I really need to get in there, come on. We need to wait for things to settle down. Let me in, okay? This is really getting tedious. There's nothing we can do. Let's come back some other time. That's about enough out of you. Give it up, alright? How many times do I have to tell you, no, you're not getting in? Hey! Cut this nonsense and clear out of here! Metal Gear says, there's nothing we can do. Let's come back some other time. What are you doing? Stop that! I have nothing to say to you. Show me the money! Alright, let's restore. So that's why I saved. I can only show the junk ID. Alright. What happens if I remove my mask? Maybe I'll take this mask off. Excuse me, sir, the manager says, but during masquerade hour you have to keep your mask on. If not, we'll have to ask you to leave. Alright, I'll leave it on. I'm sorry, but it's the rules. You'll have to leave. So we got call and order. Let's order a drink first. Bartender, give me a moonsault, will ya? Here you are. Boop. Ah, that really hits the spot. How about another one of those moonsaults? Here you are. Killian, you're on duty. I wonder if he can get drunk. Another moonsault! Whoa, I think all those drinks are starting to get to me. Would you please stop this? Keep going. You are probably still suffering from the effects of your drink. That's it. I've had it. No more drinking for me. I don't know if this is going to screw things up, so let me just... What are you doing wrong? Sounds like a thing. Let's go. Let's call customers. Let's call Sparkster. Yeah? What do you want? Gibson. Nope. Ain't never seen him. Oh, a movie actor? He's not a movie actor. Sunscreen? Never seen him. I don't know if he's gonna have anything to say about any of this stuff. Probably not. When you going home? Not get so depressed, Gillian. You'll be able to live with Jamie again sometimes. I thought I was showing him the thing. I guess I looked at it. A home and a family, huh? Those may not go along too well with being a junker. Show the... scrap of paper. Alright. Thank you very much. You've been quite helpful. Hey, don't bother me. What you want, anyway? What are you talking about? How's the deal with this guy? This isn't working. It doesn't appear that we'll be able to get anything worthwhile. I'm not done, damn you. But this Mr. Uedo, whatever. I'll call the Ueda character from Lethal Enforcers. What's the matter? I don't want anything pushed on me, man. I don't understand that hard stuff. Hard stuff. Hey, who knows, man? Contra. I'll call the Contra guy. You need something? Nah, never seen him. Alright. Call the Castlevania pair. What? We haven't done nothing. Haven't done nothing. Then you have done something. Gotta watch out for those double negatives. I don't understand what you talk about. A funny way of talking. You recognize him or what? Oh, damn it!
What the? Hey, this guy's a junker!
I hit the wrong thing! Damn it. Try one more time. Alright, never mind. Call the dancer? I'll call Isabella. Hey! Isabella! Over here! Hello there! Oh my. Hi there, boys! I'm Isabella Velvet. Is there something I can do for you? A mummy and... a robot? Oh my god, what a knockout! And that leather outfit! What's wrong? Do you find me attractive? That's a silly question. Geez, look at the size of those eyes on her! It's amazing what 21st century technology is capable of. What's wrong, Gillian? Gillian says, gotta love these actresses. Jamie looks like a little boy compared to this woman. Gillian, what are you mumbling about? Oh, she was saying that out loud. Please don't stare at me like that. I'm shy and you're embarrassing me. Are you kidding me? You dance on stage in front of so many people. You're a pretty good-looking guy. Passionate lips, fair-skinned. Gillian's like, I'm wearing a mask. I wouldn't mind letting you take me out for dinner or something. What about after dinner? Well, that all depends on you. Metal, did you hear that? Don't forget that we're in the middle of an investigation, Metal Gear says. Just relax, Metal. I'll buy you a cute little robot to play with later. So, Isabella, when would you like to go out? What? Did you think I was serious? I was just kidding. What? Just kidding? Come on, with that mummy mask, I can't even tell what you look like. Well, it would appear that she really took you for a ride. And then I guess we whacked him. Ouch! That's about enough, right? Consider yourself lucky for being able to get such a close look at me. Now, don't you let those eyes wander with someone as gorgeous as me standing right in front of you. Well, you were telling me not to look at you. Now you're telling me to look at you. Oh, sorry. We can't investigate? Hey, just where do you think you're looking? Jeez, 1 minute is don't stare like that, the next is don't let your eyes wander. Make up your mind, woman. Exactly what I was saying. Alright, investigate her. I'll investigate her! No, I think it's best if I handle it. I can manage by myself. What's wrong? Aren't you going to investigate me? No, that's alright. It would probably take too long to check these you out. Such bad jokes. We don't really need to conduct an investigation, do we, Metal? Well, I guess you're right. Liar. Metal, stop that vulgar nonsense. You have to learn to be more mature. What? Have I done something wrong? So you do like this. What are you talking about? Look at yourself. Be careful, you'll have the chief angry at you again. Was that a threat? Gillian says. Call it a promise. You're such an annoying little yutz. Yutz? Alright, so... we can ask her for an autograph or on a date. And then we can ask her stuff. Video phone number. Isabella, would you mind giving me your phone number? No way. I'm afraid I can't tell you. About Gibson. I don't know who you're talking about. Do you have a picture or something? We do. I'll show you momentarily. Future projects. That's right. You know, I have a new holographic movie that starts shooting next month, and I have to start studying my lines, so... and I've got a virtual reality job coming up, too. And a couple of offers for some TV soaps. You're quite busy, aren't you? I won't be able to dance again here for some time. What kind of men do you like? Let's see. Somebody really masculine who you could depend on. You know, the kind of guy who grabs you and says, "Come on, baby, follow me." Somebody with well-formed opinions, but I hate guys who aren't flexible. Well, that about rules you out, Gillian. You shut up. What about career preferences? Well, investigators are really strong and masculine types. I was always a big fan of crime dramas when I was little. Still, it really doesn't matter as long as you like the guy. Alright. We're out of questions. For an autograph. Can I have your autograph? My autograph? Well, let's see. I don't have anything to write with. Oh, how about this? Smooch? Whoa! Ah, I saw that. I'm telling Jamie, Metal Gear says. Oh, damn it. I think that's enough. That was a special exception, you know. Oh, come on. Men are never satisfied. They always want more. You're going to hurt yourself if you try much harder. Isabella? Look into my eyes. Open your heart. Oh, God. What kind of a line is that supposed to be? So a kiss just isn't good enough for you, huh? You know I've always cared deeply for you. Spare me your tacky come-ons, okay? Well, that makes two women who have dumped you. How could you dump me? Well, was there some problem with my approach? No, Metal Gear says, the problem is you. Well, you know, they say that many women are uncomfortable around particularly handsome men. Whatever you say, Gillian. I'm into much younger guys than you anyway. Alright, so... possessions. Before I show her anything else, I'm not showing her the junker. You know what? I'm gonna wait till after anyway, so. I am gonna show her the ID, but after this stuff. What? I really don't know. Sorry, no idea. You don't have any special, stuff. Don't you just hate the strong ultraviolet in the summer? Alright, let's just save really quick. I'm gonna show her my goods. My junker ID. What?
You're in the wrong joint, buddy! Forget about the check! Just get out of my place now!
Wow. Even... privately... I guess... are we up on stage? I had a... thought we were backstage. Well, she doesn't like us showing it anyway, so... had a feeling, so... let's show her the photo. This guy? I might have met him somewhere. No, I can't remember. Metal Gear says she seems like she might be able to remember. Sure again. Take a careful look, okay? Oh, that's right. This was the guy who got sick after eating buffalo. I remember him.